This is a replay in the Scan Invitational tournament. This is the first round, and the matchup is between AggonyDuck and Jonasnee. AggonyDuck is commanding Tylis, and Jonasnee is commanding the Boii, and these factions were used heavily throughout the tournament. They are two of the safest and decidedly strongest melee factions in the game. And the game is currently dominated by very heavy melee spams. They are safe, they are easy to use, and they don't require as much micro as, say, a skirmish faction. And also on these maps, the melee rushes are just so much more viable with the terrain and with the forests that are going to negate the effectiveness of cavalry. So for Jonasnee, we have 6 Axe Warriors, we have 3 Oathsworn, we have 3 Sword Followers, and I am very skeptical of this build because the Axe Warriors are poor mainline infantry. They need cavalry and other infantry to support them in order to get them the kills they need. 2 Levy Freemen for supporting against enemy cavalry. For AggonyDuck, we have 2 Celtic Warriors in hiding way over there. We have 2 Thracian Warriors on each flank, very strong against cavalry. We have 3 Raiding Horse. These are great units, the best matched for price. They are the best javelin cavalry in the game. The thing with these units is that since Tylis has no good mid-tier cavalry, these units need to perform a dual role in first skirmishing and then going for rear charges and skirmishers. We have a line of tribals, of course, for Duck. He has a center consisting of, I believe he has 6 tribal warriors, very standard stuff. He has an Oathsworn, 2 Oathsworn in total, Oathsworn general. Then we have 2 Celtic warriors on the flanks, and the general of AggonyDuck is a commander. So usually you will see a strategist general for the Oathsworn, because the strategist general is going to be able to use headhunt and battle rhythm to increase his combat prowess, and then it's going to be able to use second wind to reduce the stamina sapping effects of battle rhythm and headhunt. But commander is not a bad choice for Tylis, because the tribal warriors have low morale for their price. They have 55 morale, while the sword followers have 65 morale. And both players are rushing towards this hill here, this ridge. Getting the downhill charges on the ridge is going to be extremely important. Jonasnee has the more compact force, but already the javelin cavalry are going to start skirmishing against the Oathsworn general of Jonasnee. And this is bad for the Oathsworn general, but he gets up some javelins, and he actually kills 12 raiding horse by that one volley. So very nice volley. Jonas is going to start screening with this levy freeman, and this is how you counter the raiding horse. He's doing something nice here in running them around the heavy horse, trying to catch the raiding horsemen, but they're not really going to be able to catch them because the raiding horse are so fast. The heavy horse are going to take damage, and this is pulling away and doing a lot of damage to the only cavalry support that the Boii has. So very dangerous what Jonasnee is doing here. He's just losing so much heavy horse and not getting anything in return for it. So Duck is going to be able to move up to the hill pretty much unopposed, since Jonasnee pulled away his heavy horse here. And there are too many infantry units here, so the heavy horse need to go back to the safety of their own infantry contingent. Just so much damage being done by the raiding horse, and this shows how extremely deadly raiding horse is. If we're getting attack orders from the tribal warriors here, they're going to wreck the heavy horse with javelins, but it doesn't look like the attack orders are incoming just yet. It's almost like they don't need to, because there are so many javelins incoming. Heavy horse coming downhill against the tribals, follow up with the Oathsworn, very nicely done by Jonasnee. But the raiding horse are just surrounding the heavy horse and neutralizing them. So much damage being done to the heavy horse of Jonasnee, and the heavy horse are essentially out of the game. AggonyDuck is on the hill, fighting down towards the Axe Warriors. Celtic Warriors are going to murder Axe Warriors on the charge downhill. Look at the Axe Warriors just dying to Oathsworn and Celtic Warriors. And this is what happens when Axe Warriors are not supported. The Oathsworn general of Jonasnee is getting swamped with units. An additional Oathsworn unit is coming in to support. The heavy horse of Jonasnee is out of the game. Overall, Panda Warrior is in the most advantageous terrain here. He's able to engage the Sword Followers and Axe Warriors and do a lot of damage because he's fighting downhill. And at this point in the battle, there is not much Jonasnee can do. All of his units are engaged. The Raiding Horse are going to be able to go in for rear charges. And rare charges against these units, that's really going to, even though it's uphill, the morale penalty is going to break them pretty much instantly. You can see they're all getting in the red here, and here we have three units of Axe Warriors just getting, just routing from being attacked in the rear by Raiding Horse. Very nicely done here by Duck. And I don't think either Jonasnee or Duck, I don't think they're playing Rome too much anymore. Duck was very active for a while. Jonasnee played mostly in Shogun, I believe. Both were good players, with the edge going to AggonyDuck. He was an absolute beast in Shogun 2, almost achieving legendary status in that game. And he hasn't been very active in the latest patches in Rome 2, but I think you'll see that he proves that he definitely deserved a spot in this tournament. The Axe Warriors are getting blobbed up, but they are not being effective here. They're just losing so badly. Raiding Horse coming in beautifully and breaking the Axe Warriors and Sword Followers of Boii. The general of the Oldstone general is just going down so quickly, and he's a strategist, so he's going to be able to use Second Wind, but it's not really going to help him when he's surrounded by this amount of units. Tribal Warriors just tanking it out against the Oldstone. Levy Thracian Warriors are destroying Levy Freeman, and when AggonyDuck made it first up to this hill, there wasn't much Jonasnee could do about it. But if AggonyDuck would just have stayed on the hill, Jonasnee would have had to make something else work. And if you look at the terrain here, the reason why a lot of players pick Armavir when they are attacking is because look at the terrain. If you pick the right attacker direction, Armavir, you're going to be able to fight downhill the entire battle. So Jonasnee did something smart in moving up on the ridge, because that could have enabled him to be doing downhill charges here. But overall, this attacker direction for Armavir is going to be devastating for whichever player gets pitted at the bottom of this ravine. So Jonasnee's units are still holding out. Oathsorn and Sword Followers have very high morale, but the units that are left are just so blobbed up that Panda is going to be able to surround Jonasnee's units on all sides. And this is pretty much a GG. It's just a matter of grinding it out against these remaining units. Thracian Warriors already with many kills. You should see the kills start to increase massively now as well. They're just hammering into the Oathsorn and destroying them on the charge. These Thracian Warriors, their high melee attack and their good charge bonus, high amount of armor piercing, is going to make them so deadly even against elite swords. And if elite swords are engaged and these Thracian Warriors get a clean charge into the rear, it's almost like seeing a shock cavalry unit charging in because of the casualties they're able to inflict on even very heavy, very good units. So I think bringing six Axe Warriors for Jonasnee was very risky. The idea was probably to take care of the Tribal Warriors with the Axe Warriors, but the Axe Warriors are going to lose massively on the charge to Tribals. They need to be supported, so more Heavy Horse for Boye would definitely be good, and even Celtic Warriors to go in together with the Axe Warriors. So I think the kills here will be very telling. The Axe Warriors are not able to do much. The cavalry was neutralized. The Oathsorn did okay, but not nearly enough. And they didn't outperform even the Sword Followers in this battle. Well, if we look at the Oathsorn of Panda, they hardly took any casualties, did a lot of damage. The Tribals did well. The Thracian Warriors, being able to rush in and support, just show how deadly they can be if they're kept in reserve and then rushed in the late game. So Duck brought the bigger build, he brought the stronger build, because there are just too many Axe Warriors here for Jonasnee. So this was the first battle, it's best of three, and in the next battle we'll see how it goes again between AggonyDuck and Jonasnee. Strength and honor.